So welcome to this introduction to permaculture. My name's Claudia, and I really would love to give you some tools to start helping you support on your projects, to bring some of the wisdom of nature through so you can make it even more connected and designed, well-designed projects that have really good outcomes. I want to just briefly, at the beginning of this permaculture bit, light this candle to dedicate everything that I'm going to teach you and that you're going to be doing to what's called the children's fire. So it's a fire that used to sit in the circle of Indigenous peoples so that as they took decisions, they would keep in mind always that it was for the good of the children and the children's children for many generations forward, and not just human, but of all beings. So that we remember that that's what we're doing this for. And so I just want to give you an introduction to permaculture in this first unit and just explain the key components of it and where it came from. And this is really one of the key things to keep in mind, a forest system. And the originators of permaculture were studying forest ecology and looking at all the intricacies and how things are connected and all the different species that live together in a forest and seeing how abundant it was. And then comparing that with how they were living and how agriculture is done in a really sterile way, growing just one crop. And the same with forestry, just trees in rows and not many different other species there. And even how humans are designing human settlements. It's all monoculture. And what we're seeing in this forest ecology is a lot of diversity, a lot of interaction, a lot of cooperation. And so what we're doing in permaculture is taking that wisdom from nature and applying that to our human systems. So in terms of the components of permaculture, there are three. One is the ecology and the principles that come from that. Secondly, there is the fact that it's a design system. So it's a method to get us from A to B. Having a current situation, and it might be an empty garden or a garden you're not pleased with, or whatever land-based thing that you want to make more productive and more aligned to nature. Or it could be a social situation. Either way, anywhere where you want to change something, you can use permaculture design as the method to get you from A to B. So we'll look at some examples of that. And the third component of permaculture is that it has an ethical basis. So there's three simple ethics that give us some guidelines to help us make decisions around what is appropriate to put into a design. So the first one of those is earth care, that everything that we do within permaculture has in mind that we do it with care for the earth. So the choices that we make, the materials that we choose, that it wouldn't be harming the earth. Secondly, that there is a people element to that. People care, so that in projects and in our designs, that we do it with in mind, looking after the social relations and creating a good community and looking after ourselves in the first instance also. So making sure that the humans are in a good place so that they can do the practical that looks after the earth. And then the third ethic is fair shares. And that is about living within our means so that when we do any projects, they create and fulfill our needs. If there was any surplus, that we think about sharing that surplus with others. And that might be in projects that that we give produce that is produced to people that are homeless, for example, or anyone else that also has a need for that. So those are the three components of permaculture. Just to say a little bit about the word itself. As our permaculture comes from permanent agriculture, so thinking about how we grow things originally, but it also links directly to permanent culture, so that the earth aspect and the social aspect, also the people care. So it's also about how we set ourselves up in a good way in our cultures so that we can create a more abundant and resilient place to be. So that's it for now. I will set you some homework to find out a little bit more. You'll find that in your written units. Thank you.